me now.
This is the Modern Eater Show.
That's right, boy. I'm starving.
And now it's time for In the Kitchen.
How am I supposed to keep on feeding you? Kill people?
Brought to you by
Proud Souls Barbecue and Provisions. Award-winning competition cooks and purveyors of specialty barbecue supplies right here in Denver, Colorado. ProudSoulsBBQ.com.
Feed me all night long.
Okay, 3 minutes of the...
It's going to be a whirlwind right here, man.
Right here.
Bring it.
Back to the kitchen right now, and we are in the kitchen. We've been tap dancing a little bit, but Diana Starkus, here you are with us.
I am.
I love it.
Diana.
And your husband here, Chris, chef. Here you guys are. I'm fascinated. And Amber, you're actually a fan of their Instagram.
Yeah,
right?
You guys have a great Instagram. Thank you.
Yeah.
And their cat that I saw, is that Seven?
Seven,
yes,
yep.
Sir. Mm-hmm.
Seven. That's cool.
He has equal parts mischief and just pure love. I love it.
Can you talk about the Lost Creek Micro Farm, please?
Sure. So when we landed in Lakewood, we found this wonderful place where we have about a third of an acre next door to our house. And at first, I tilled about a third of it because I always have had some sort of large-ish garden. And the rest, I think, our son used to make, like, mountain bike jumps or something.
Yeah.
And then the next year we just did the whole thing and we started adding chickens and bees. And so now we've intensively farmed there for about 3 seasons and just had a lot of just support from the Denver community in different ways that I never even expected.
Oh, like, my God, I want to do an hour of talk radio with you so bad. And here we are with just a few minutes. The impression that you leave on all of us, because I love farming, especially. Would you call it urban farming?
Absolutely.
Yeah, I would too.
Literally, we can walk out onto 20th and look down and see Sloan's Lake and then downtown Denver. That's what's amazing about this is just we're within a stone's throw of an urban area.
I'm a balcony gardener.
Yeah.
Shows you how crazy I am. But that's what I have to work with, right?
Yes,
I mean,
sure,
so you take what you work with. Talk about that just for a minute of utilizing the land that you have.
So the land that I have, it took me about, you know, 4 seasons to figure out where all of the sunlight falls and how the water runs. And there's even like this nice little channel of clay that makes me absolutely crazy. It's like the bane of my existence.
Yeah.
However, it helps us grow basil over there like anything or cilantro. So, you know, it's just been something that's been an evolution. You know, it's a small piece of land, so we've intensively farmed for about 3 seasons, and now it's time to let it go fallow and rest the soil. So because we don't have a lot of acreage, there's some considerations to make that make it definitely urban.
Oh, my God. And what you guys are doing with bees to kind of get the flora of the land right where you want it to be able to utilize this land for exactly what you want to.
Yeah, it's like getting 50,000, 70,000 best friends for a farmer. Yeah.
I'm glad you're here with us tonight. And your husband just shines. He truly does.
He's the best.
This is the first time we've had the opportunity to meet you. Amber's a friend, a fan of your Instagram.
She's my new friend.
You should look at her Instagram too. Strohauer Farms as well. Okay, guys, if you were to talk, Chris, you guys, 1 second here, 20 seconds on if you want to find out more information about the farm itself, because I think a lot of information you guys put out there.
Well, you can find us on social media at Lost Creek Micro Farm, and then also at our website, which is the same, lostcreekmicrofarm.com. It's pretty simple, just like the farm. You know, it's like put seeds in, water them, sun, just same thing.
Absolutely.
So, easy to find us.
Probably
I love it.
Questions, too.
Yeah. We could talk for hours. Unfortunately, we have to break.
Great.
We'll be right back.